What's up, guys? Snape. How you doing here? I'm giving you some Halo Reach gameplay. No, that's actually not of me. Again, he grabs Snipe right here. Right. So this is my boy Alpha Guardian X, okay? He sent me in a submission on my YouTube. Send me inbox, guys. So feel free to do so yourself if you want to. Anyway, so we start this off where he grabs the Snipe. And I'm going to say, nice, this is actually triple kill right here, nice. I'm going to say right now that you plan about 3, maybe 4, possibly 5? 3 to 4 sensitivity. You might be playing higher or lower. It all actually depends on the controller and how sensitive the joysticks are in there. Alright, so let me just say right here, I don't know if you're playing with your team here, if this is friends you have here, but first off, teammates help. And I'll explain a little later as we go on. But that was a nice grenade over there in the corner. I'm a little late on saying that. And that guy right there, Micah Man or whatever his name is, that guy loves the damn turret. You guys will see that plenty in this video. I think it's pretty funny. Anybody who carries around Big Betsy, that's my name for it, is funny. Okay, so right there, you focus on the sniper with your teammate right in front of the sniper and a guy in court. What you should have done was prioritize. Know that your teammate was coming up on their sniper. This guy is an idiot. In the corner. I mean, he had shotgun. He should have just not been in that situation. He's all the way in your side. He shouldn't be in your side. Anyway, right here, also another prioritized situation. I'm actually going to pause that and rewind it a second. Let's rewind it. See the guy get killed because he's an idiot. You should prioritize right here, and what I mean by that is that this guy was a guy that your teammate was first shooting at. He was, I think he was three shot, four shot possibly. But he was the one that was on level while your teammate runs through pillars, right? He was the one that was doing the most hurt to your teammate. It's just, again, this is if you're playing with friends. That might not even be a friend of yours. It might have been a random and you didn't care, which is fine. Over here, you kind of spam your DMR. Later on, you show some goodness with your DMR. You show some precision with it, as in pacing your shots, and then you show non-precision, where you just kind of spam. And it's acceptable. Both of them are acceptable because in certain situations they're both supposed to be used. Okay, so you see your sniper get taken somewhere, and you're going after him, and then you meet up with these three guys. You get that assist. Okay, that means that first guy's done for, because you got the assist for it. You got the second guy. The third guy was the one with the invis that got away with the sniper. You see so somewhere else, and then you find out your teammate was the guy that killed him. I right here. I don't know what you were doing. I'm going to assume right now that you were waiting and you were kind of vulturing, waiting for him to die, which you pick up the sniper and you go right at it, okay? So you should know by now that a sniper is laid up in their snipe hut, and you go and get these. Oh, not a double kill? I thought that was double kill. Sorry, this is only like the second time I watched this video, but I like having like a fresh experience when I watch videos. Right there, instead of shooting him once and getting him one shot, that means he has sniper and he knows, he's aware there's another sniper on the field. You should have moved right there, right where you are pretty much right now, and took that shot. Because you would have got the headshot because he's standstilling, which is just standstill DMRing / sniping. Right here, that bloodshot sucks. If you watch my video where I'm actually the one playing, I think I had a bloodshot. It's on Sanctuary, yeah, and I got pissed. That guy stood around on the nade. Sucks for him. Something I would like to ask you, Alpha, or... your name on YouTube, I forgot. It's like Rhinel or something. Either one. I would like to know if you have Turtle Beaches or if you have regular headsets. Because there's a couple parts where you stand on like a nade. By the way, great nade right there. You stand on a nade and it just kind of bounces there and skitters there for a little bit. And you could have like maybe jumped away so you lived it. But instead you just sat on it. And I don't know, maybe it's just you don't have Turtle Beaches or you forgot the grenade was there. Which, you know, again, happens. Smart move dropping the AR because you realize that it's not going to spawn. But later on, you drop the sniper at, it's like 8:17 or 8:18, so it's going to spawn at 6-something, right? Or, yeah, 6-something. You shot your teammate in the ass right there. Great. So, I don't know if you know weapon times for the level. But just in case you don't, it's always beneficial to hold down weapon times. Like I said, snipers relative 2 hours. Or, wow, 2 hours. 2 minutes. Let's try that again. Over here, you're shooting at these kids. You gotta prioritize a bit. You saw your teammate was shooting someone. I'm not going to go back. But you saw your teammate was shooting someone, and he actually escapes, and your teammate dies. You should have just leeched off and just took that kill. It's all how you play. You get him in the long run, like you just got him there. You were trying to go for that triple, I saw it, and you missed the guy sniping over there. Yeah. You saw him before you switch over to the guy at jump up. It's whatever. That would have been a nice headshot, let me just say. Actually, there's a little something later on that if I were you, I would have been so pissed, and that's where you lose the rampage. And it's not even off of a kill, but yeah, right here you go back, and you know Sniper. I guess you might have known Sniper was supposed to respawn soon, but it was a good thing to drop the empty sniper early. So you just sit on here, and you know this guy's waiting for his sniper too, and yeah, he already has sniper. I think that's his old one because his new one's right there. I don't understand how he has a snipe then. Either way, you got it. You got it at the right time, the good time. Oh wait, this is Asylum. Snipers spawn different times. My bad. It's certain levels. Certain levels have different spawn times for the weapons. Like Sanctuary, I know the Sanctuary ones because that's MLG and that's what I mostly play. Asylum is different. I forgot. It's like every minute 30, if I'm right. Yeah, so you get it again. I think this is where you just start going on the tear, and that's what gets you the rampage. And it's these kids that... These kids did not see you coming at all. Like, that kid, why is he standing in the corner still when he's one shot? I think you hit him right here also, right? He's in the corner. Oh, no. He ran away. But you still get this kid, and that starts the killing frenzy. Oh, there he goes right there. He's still in the corner. Like, it was a stupid move on his part. Good play on your part, knowing he was still there and calling it out. Or not calling it out, but being reminded. You're just sitting on objective, which is... Objective is a fine place to sit on. But yeah, like over there, if your teammates were actually talking to you, again, I don't know. I can't hear chatter through theater mode, but nice headshot there. That guy must be pissed. That was a killjoy. I'm more than sure he was on a killing spree / killing sprint frenzy. But yeah, when your teammates are getting shot over there, you want to go and assist them, because even if you guys are up by, let's see your score when you get out of this. It is 51-36. Before the last two kills that you guys got, you were at obviously 49-36. Nice headshot. One kill could be downfall. I guess I say that more just because I play more pro games. Like I actually play with some pros. I play with some semi pros and I play with some pros from Halo 2 and 3. So I'm more oriented in the pro gameplay. But you want to make sure that all your people are set up. And the fact that your two teammates died, that could have been bad for you. Luckily, the guy didn't push up and then go on you and then jump on you, which is awesome. You know, obviously, that's awesome for you. But when you're playing with a team-wise, instead of just sitting on objective, move around a bit. Be a little bit more free with yourself because you want to be able to move around. And this guy failed, and you got so lucky, dude. Good job for the survivor. That I gave you a survivor medal for that one. Ching. Right, so again, you're still sitting on the objective, and at this point, I play a little bit more free, where I move around because I'm not my team's main sniper. My boy BJ is. But usually what he does is, like I say, he drifts around. Even when we're playing Team Slayer instead of MLG or practicing for a match, we're moving around. And he always moves around. He especially does work on the sniper hut. Because where you're looking at right now is rocks. And when we play, this guy... Let me just say you got very lucky. I think you got a little nervous there, and that's why that beat down. But you got him. That was great. That was good work. And right here, I would have been pissed. Because I think it's about to happen now. There it goes. Black screen of death. And that thing resets the whole game for you and resets your... kill streak. What is this, Call of Duty? It resets your killing frenzy and your rampage and brings it back down. But plus side is weapon drop. you capitalized on that. So you continue, got that snipe ammo. You're really consistent on the snipe ammo, so I'm gonna guess that you know the snipe times or the times for the weapons. That's always good, like I said. And what's with your teammates? What's with both of you guys? Both of your team have this thing for Betty, you know, old Betty. Big Betty. You guys love that machine gun. I think it's hilarious when I see kids running around with it. But whatever. So you're trying to snipe this kid that's in their snipe with snipe. And that's good. That stops this guy from picking you guys off. When you have a match like this, if you don't have anybody to play Halo with, I friend requested you, man. You see my friend request already. You can accept it, and every once in a while we'll play. Maybe you can even get in my clan. I don't know. But for now, if you want a good showing of teamwork, just if you're on, I'll send you a message, and me and you can play a bit. If you don't have anybody to play with. But when you're playing games like this and you have a good team with you and you have people you trust, what you want to do is my bad. I'm gonna keep going even though the video's done. You want to set up on this level. So what I mean by set up is, let's bring this back so I don't see this big ass screen in my way. Okay. So what I mean by set up is, here's a good setup. You set up one car, so they have lines at sniper. They put shots on him, put grenade shots on him. You have one either in your hut over here, or on their car so that they can put shots all around their field, okay? That includes their snipe hut. You can see the snipers over there. That includes their objective, and that includes their rocks. Because let me just tell you, even on Asylum where it's Team Slayer, it's not like MLG where the spawns are really easy to guess, but the spawns, they usually spawn around here, all across his back wall, okay? You want to set up nice and easy on there, and whenever you have to, you fall back, and that fourth guy that you have just floating around, that's usually me. I'll go cover my sniper, which would be BJ. I'll cover him, put shots up here, jump onto their car, take a couple shots, move around, go through the ring, look at their hut, see if anybody needs help, if my boy at car needs help, and just float around. You can always box them around these two areas, which is rocks and objective. Every once in a while, they'll spawn on their turret slash jet, because jet is for MLG, and you'll be fine. But you did pretty good here. I think if it was harder opponents, like if you don't want to stand too still with the sniper, that's what I mean by that. You want to move around a lot more. Be more consistent with your DMR shots. So what I mean by that is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where you're just spamming down the trigger, because that can get you killed really easily. But all in all, it was pretty solid gameplay. Unfortunately, black screen did screw you up for the killings, because I'm more than sure you could have got, what is the next one? I think it's Untouchable. Yeah, I think Untouchable is after Rampage. Yeah, these kids, man. These kids. Oh, they quit out too. I didn't even notice that. Wow. Mike, man. Yeah, that guy, I love this turret. So, great game, man. And for my YouTube people, don't forget, you can send me videos and I will do some little tips on it. And possibly, if you guys need it, you guys can play with me at some point. I'll teach you little tips for levels. I'll probably be putting out call-out videos so that you guys, not only for my clan, so my clan members, my new ones, know the call-outs, but also so that you guys, if you guys are interested in knowing call-outs, you guys can get that too. I'll be doing MLG levels and regular levels, because I know not all of you play MLG. I know some of you guys play Boardwalk and this one, Asylum. So yeah, guys, great gameplay at Alpha, and thank you for submitting. Hope you guys enjoyed.